Hey everybody, I'm going to go into painting a little bit more in this video. I'll be the first to tell you I'm not the best, and I hate spraying in my shop even. But on some things you want it to look good, you got to spray it. So I painted this once, but I'm not happy with it. It's light right here. I didn't get enough coverage, and it's kind of checkered. I'm going to sand it down, wet sand it down again and respray it. I'll show you how I do it. Here's the dashboard. I sanded down and primed. A lot of you guys probably just use regular primer. I like this filler primer. It's about three times as much, but gives you a better paint job. I don't know if you can see the little pitted corrosion marks in that. You go over it enough with this, you won't even be able to see it. It's got heavy pigment in it that drops down in the little pits. They don't even sell it everywhere. You gotta get it at, I gotta get it at AutoZone. They only usually have a couple cans. Store your spray cans like that upside down. They'll work when you go to use them 6 months from now. When you store it like that, all the pigments up around the entrance of that pipe, the pipe in there, just gets a big block of gel there. You can't shake it up because it's frozen in the hose. Turn it upside down, hose is nice and empty on the end till you need it. Believe me, I'm no expert at painting. Here's the two guns I'm going to use. This is for little pieces that are like that dashboard. Not too big. You don't want to waste paint. Use this one on the rest of it. This is a HVLP gun. High volume, low pressure. Gravity feed. This won't spit on you like the old kind. It's a bottom feed. And plus you have a regulator on it. Keep your pressure at about 40 PSI. These guns are real tricky to learn how to use. Took me a while, I'm still learning. Like on this paint, don't thin it to what it tells you, or you'll never work. You almost gotta cut it in half. With this enamel so thick, and you put that hardener in it. I tell you, cut it with Zylol, but my tractor buddies use this stuff. It's a lot better. A little expensive though, and hard to get. Try to mix this up. Some measuring cups. Gonna mix about 8 ounces up. Goes farther than you think. Gonna use about. I don't have the right paint measuring stuff, so I'm using a tablespoon. I'm going to start off with four tablespoons to 8 ounces. Might even go thinner than that. If you get too thick, it won't atomize right. It'll sputter and your paint will look like crap. You notice I'm putting that thinner in here. It's going to make it go through the strainer a little easier. And another thing, I should already have these on. It's enamel and it's hard to get off your hands. A lot easier than scrubbing your hands raw or digging under your fingernails with your pocket knife. Now I won't leave no prints. Nobody can blame me for the paint job. Oh, shush up, little man. What are you doing? Got a bug or something. A lot of you guys probably know how to paint a lot better than me, but maybe this will help somebody. I'm no expert on painting, but with the old suction guns, I used to tell by the way it dripped off the stick. You want it running off, not like water, but not thick either. Getting close. Maybe a hair more thinner. Not done yet either. We got to put the hardener in there. This much paint, 8 ounces, I probably just put about half a teaspoon. How's that for scientific measurement? I like a little more hardener anyway. I think it makes the gloss pop. On this hardener, it goes bad once you open it. Once the air gets to it, it won't last very long. It's $12 for that little bottle. What you can do is turn your MIG wire feed welder on and spray argon in there before you put the lid on. It'll last longer. All right. Let's see what that looks like. I know from experience, it'll be one more tablespoon. So, see, I told you, Jim, you gotta cut it in half. That enamel's some mean stuff. It's what makes it a good paint job. Ooh, that's real good. Get it too thin, and then the thinner dries out before the paint, and you lose your gloss. Get too much paint, and it'll bubble up. You need to experiment a little with your paint gun. I'm sure they're all a little different. But once you put that hardener in there, you gotta wait 20, 30 minutes to spray it. On these guns, this is your max airflow setting. No matter what this says, this allows you can cap the amount of air that'll get in there, so don't blow your seals. And on this gun, this is your fan size, spreads out. This is your amount of paint. You should run it all the way in and back it out 2 1/4 to start with. It's a good setting. Try to get this gun set up. Get you an old cardboard box or something to spray on. Not bad. What you do is you want to pull the trigger one time. Look at your thing. My fan's crooked. Maybe a little more air. Oh, that's getting better. You want it even all in there. I'm gonna re-sand this piece, wet sand it. That paper stays clean. In between sandings, you gotta dry it off real good. Look at it. Definitely wear one of these. That enamel's some mean stuff.
No, I have no father.
They get tacky for about 15 minutes. Put another coat on it. Put it on the heater for a minute. Alright, got the belt cover done. We're done with red today. Got the gun cleaned up. I'm gonna paint this black. We'll paint that dashboard black. The chrome was too screwed up to save. I'm gonna paint it black to match that. Had that powder coated. Let these dry for a minute. I'll put them in. There you go. Got the dashboard in. I'm not putting the screws in. It's still, the paint's still a little wet. But I don't want to scratch it. The belt cover on, looks a lot better. No expert, but that's how I do it. Hope this helps somebody. My tractor guys had to show me. Just got to experiment with your gun and see what happens. Pretty good.